Today also marks the anniversary of Japan's surrender in World War II. Some Japanese politicians chose to mark the occasion by paying their respects to the controversial Yasukuni War Shrine honoring Class A war criminals.
Commemorations to mark the anniversary of the day Japan laid down its arms.
We're trying to keep peace between these two sides. They're still right-wing.
Washington has been critical of Mr. Abe's decision to visit the shrine. So little heads up for you guys about audio. This video was recorded over 7 months because my original microphone broke and I recorded other parts with a new one. I also re-edited this video multiple times because I wasn't really happy about it. Another thing I want to say is that the comment section of this video is probably going to be a shitstorm, and there are probably a lot of pro-imperial apologizers in the comment section saying Japan did nothing wrong, but the fact of the matter is they did. So in this day of age, companies really like to force their political opinion into their media. Now, I always try to avoid any politics in my videos because history has already been written and it doesn't need to be rewritten by biased political views. And also, people are really getting tired of these forced political statements in their favorite franchises. And as we know, this will kill off any big franchise.
Oh my God!
The history of Yasukuni Shrine goes back to the Meiji era, and soldiers have been officially enshrined here until 1945. Fact of the matter is that they have been enshrining war criminals into this shrine until 1980. Of course, there are honorable people enshrined here, and these soldiers are honored for giving their lives for the emperor. Real problems with this shrine starts after the 1931 mark. It's not that these soldiers don't deserve a memorial place somewhere, it's the soldiers that don't deserve it and soldiers that were forced to fight for the Japanese, because many Koreans and other foreign soldiers are enshrined here, and this is where it gets complicated. The fact of the matter is that so many people that lost their loved ones needed to face the facts that their sons or husbands are enshrined in this imperial shrine. And they probably could never visit them or say goodbye. And I could make a whole other video about this topic. And if you do some research about this and the religion, you also come across some people that think these foreign soldiers' souls are trapped in this shrine. And no matter what your stance on the religion is, this must be a terrible thing for these families that believe this to go through. After 1945, the Americans gave the Japanese government an option in the affairs of Yasukuni Shrine. The Japanese government needed to separate themselves from Yasukuni Shrine. If not, they were forced to tear it all down. So Yasukuni became privately owned. Many people give the Americans grief about this and that they were too lenient. But the Americans had to keep mass suicide in mind. They learned the hard way with the Battle of Saipan, where the civilian population committed mass suicide. And at the time, this was pretty much the best thing they could do, but not in the long run, of course. And the shrine is now owned by an ultra-nationalist company. Today, many people choose to stay clear from this topic, and there are a lot of videos on YouTube that precisely do that. A lot of these videos are from expats living in Japan, and you can see they don't really want to make the video, and they sort of want to say the truth, but they don't want to piss off their Japanese fanbase, and their fanbase that think Japan is the best country in the world. So they make a half-ass video beating around the bush and just simply lie about it. But I'm not that kind of person. I know people wanted to see me go to this place, and I'm pretty much going to tell the history. And the fact of the matter is, this is a shitty place. I would not recommend any tourists to come here. It's unpleasant, there are guards everywhere, and they will harass any foreigner with a camera. It's a really policed kind of feeling. And when I was there, they did tell a few people to stop filming, but they left me alone. Or just overlooked me. Don't know how that is possible because I'm a Dutch giant and I stick out like a sore thumb. But even though the atmosphere of this place was really unpleasant, for me this shrine and its disturbing ignorance people had for it, plus the history, made it really interesting to me. Common narrative people have is that the Japanese don't get the history at school, but this isn't entirely true. They sort of get the history, but it's a fast course and the ugly stuff is simply shrugged off. So why do people still come here and pay respects? Now, a lot of this has to do with the culture and that people also want to pay respects to the normal people that are enshrined here, and they just don't want to think about World War II because they want to forget the past and move forward. Now, another part of it is that some people still think that after the war the tribunals were just a backlash because of the war, and many of these war criminals were only punished out of spite. So do I think that this place needs to be torn down? In my opinion, no, because this place is still a really important part of history, but it needs to have the correct historical information and stop being a glorification site of the imperial age. And I know there is a museum close by, but that museum is notorious for censoring any war crimes and even lie about who started the war and give off the impression that Japan was the victim in all of this. You're the aggressor, Japan, you don't get victim points here. And like I said in my other video, you get the feeling Japan is really begging for victim points with this place. And it gets really obvious in the World War II museum that's close by the circus of a place. The Yasuko Museum is a pinnacle of Japan victim point begging and denial of the war. The museum denies war crimes and lies about who started the war. It's a real imperial pro theme park. But I will do a separate video about this. Of course, this place isn't popular in other countries. It's also not popular in Japan either. People know about it. Like I said, they get the history at school. Of course, there are always ignorant people out there, and there are ignorant people everywhere, in all countries. They like to forget history or change it if they can. But they forget, you can't change history. You need to accept it and learn about it. But that's pretty much everything I have to say about this shit stain of a place. I hope you guys that wanted to see this are pleased. I can't really make a positive video about this place, but I still hope you enjoyed watching it, because I did not enjoy making it at all. If people want to see a second video about this, I have some footage of the sort of celebration of the surrender of Japan and the protest going on around this place. So let me know in the comments below, and those comments are probably going to be a shitstorm with the worst people on the planet. But I still hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one.